Hey guys, how's it going? Just wanted to give you an update on Panama City, Florida, 2.5 months after Hurricane Michael. I know that the news has kind of stopped talking about it, just like the California wildfires and earthquakes up in Alaska. We've all been through so much as a country here recently in the end of this year, and I'm guilty of it as anybody. Once the news kind of stops talking about it, it's out of sight, out of mind. If you're not living in it, it's kind of hard to relate and really understand the big picture of what's going on, but living in it really changes your life and your outlook and things on any kind of disaster. So my heart goes out to anybody that's ever been through anything like this, any hurricane, from Katrina to Irma to Harvey to any of that stuff. Being a Floridian, we've lived through many hurricanes and stayed for them, but this thing was just on a whole other level. It was bigger than anything any of us imagined and have been through before. I believe in time it will be dubbed a Category 5 hurricane later on after the fact, just because Tyndall Air Force Base was reporting wind gusts well over 200 miles an hour and sustained winds well in Category 5 territory before they were blown away, hangars and all. I mean, this thing even flipped over a train. So what does that tell you? But I've heard that if they call it a Category 5 officially, that we won't be responsible for our insurance deductibles and things like that. So, I mean, we can't have that. So I have a feeling that later on in time, it will probably be changed in the history books. But nevertheless, we are still here. As you can see, there is just rubble everywhere. Nothing looks the same. I've driven past my parents' house 3 times because nothing looks the same anymore. If you haven't been to Panama City lately after the storm, it is a lot different. It's dangerous to drive around, especially at night when there's no street lights because they all got blown away, so it's very dark. Very few things are open, but we are blessed. We are getting by. Here's how Panama City's looking this time of year at Christmas.
It's beginning to look a lot like Christmas everywhere you go. Take a look at 5 and 10, glistening once again with candy canes and silver lanes aglow. It's beginning to look a lot like Christmas, toys in every store. But the prettiest sight to see is the holly that will be on your own front door. A pair of hop-along boots and a pistol that shoots is the wish of Barney and Ben. Dolls will talk and will go for a walk is the hope of Janice and Jen. And Mom and Dad can hardly wait for school to start again.
It's beginning to look a lot like Christmas everywhere you go.
There's a tree in the Grand Hotel, one in the park as well, the sturdy kind that doesn't mind the snow.
It's beginning to look a lot like Christmas. Soon the bells will start,
and the thing that will make them ring is the carol that you sing right within your heart.
Beginning to look a lot like Christmas. Soon the bells will start,
and the thing that will make them ring is the carol that you sing right within your heart. It's beginning to look a lot like Christmas.
Christmas,
Christmas,
Christmas, Christmas.
You have it. There's a little bit of what the town is looking like currently. We are not back in our house just yet, but we're getting there. We're getting a lot closer. We have a roof now, and so we're starting on some of the inside things like the sheetrock, and then the flooring will be next in January. We're hoping to be living back in our house towards the end of January. That's the goal, and I think we can get there. But we are so blessed to even have a house at all. So many people are just completely homeless and jobless, and it's Christmas time, and it just it doesn't really feel like it, but I know that we're all in this together. It's not just 850 strong Panama City, it's USA strong. So that's kind of what it's looking like here right now. It's really hard to look any direction without seeing some sort of damage. But we are getting through this nonetheless. My God is bigger than all of this. And despite all of the destruction and chaos and all the negative things that it's easy to focus on, I know that my God is with us. He's never left us or forsaken us. I've seen him working through all these situations and through the people and even complete strangers coming together and helping each other out. So many of you even donating monetarily or supplies, even to my family, and opening up your homes to my family immediately after the storm when we had nowhere to go. I was so thankful to be able to bring my family to Dothan, Alabama, and know that they were safe while my dad and I were here kind of working through the rubble and figuring things out. We thank you so much from the bottom of our hearts. We can never thank you enough. You know who you are. So thank you for your continued support. Thank you for your prayers. They are coveted and they are helping. So please continue to keep us lifted up. I look forward to seeing you in the new year. 2019, wherever I end up playing, I am still playing. Definitely still playing. I need to play. Need all the gigs I can get. Got bills to pay. Even trying to pay off this baby. Baby Liam. I didn't know you could finance a baby, but we pretty much did. I'm still making payments on him. Hoping to have him paid off before the warranty runs out. But I am looking forward to coming and seeing you playing in 2019. Merry Christmas to you all. Happy New Year. God bless.